I'm Lakyn and you're watching Get Music. Well, better than that is kind of, it's like my way of saying there's unlimited possibilities, you know, with life. I always try to get the best out of everything. Why not? Yes, first time was with Dan Hume, and he's an awesome guy. Stables, this Evermore's, what's it called? Studio? Evermore's Studio. The Stables is an awesome place. It's out on a farm, and that's like my perfect first experience. I loved it. And had a lot of freedom with this EP and time as well, which helped a lot because I could get real honest with my music. First time in the studio, we just kind of, the first day was real lazy, just hanged out, made eggs, I think. I kind of became a barrister over that time, making coffees, and it was good. I mean, there's been so much, just like, everything's a kind of a highlight. I mean, I get good news one day, better news the next day, and but I guess just being able to record my music and record the songs that mean a lot to me and release better than that, which, I don't know, it's just crazy to have my EP or something just around Australia and a lot of people can hear it. That's what means a lot to me, so that's the biggest highlight. Yeah, definitely. For Australian music, both of them are pretty awesome, and it's just my kind of style, and I really love Angus Stone's songwriting and Julia's voice, and yeah, they're pretty awesome. I have my ode to Bob Dylan, and it says "I shall be released" around here. That's my favorite song of his. I have Bon Iver, so the man Justin Vernon. He's an amazing songwriter that has inspired me a lot. Better Be, the Beatles. They're like my first music love, I think. I got Help on tape when I was 9, I think, for Christmas, and I don't know, all the other kids were listening to like Limp Bizkit and Linkin Park, you know, and my parents were like, why is he getting into the Beatles? But and I loved it, and I've got a few more, but I don't know, I'm not taking my top off. I don't know. I don't think so. Nah. No meet and greets planned yet, but I do meet and greet fans in the street all the time, and they come up, ask for a photo, and they say, "Oh, love your EP," and I'm like, I mean, it's really cool to see them like just randomly like that, but I'm sure there'll be a meet and greet someday. talk. Wait. I was gonna say. No, I'd rather go without clothes. If I can't talk, I can't sing. Yeah.